I've come to discuss tomorrow.
The Attorney General relayed to me your desire for a more modest ceremony.
I've changed my mind.
I'm sorry?
I said I've changed my mind. We will have a procession, and I will walk to the cathedral with the casket.
Well, even if we could resume the arrangements, I'm sure you can understand the Secret Service still has their concerns.
And President Johnson.
President Johnson would like nothing more than to fulfill your wishes, but I have to take into account his safety. The country couldn't endure another blow should any... It's not to say. If it were up to him, he would do anything that might bring you comfort.
And who is it up to, Mr. Valenti?
Well, as I'm sure you know, tomorrow we're expecting close to 100 heads of state.
103.
Yes, I'm sure that's right, and I suspect they'll make all their own decisions.
Based on what?
There's a great deal of classified intelligence that I just can't get into. We've intercepted a threat against General de Gaulle from our assets in Geneva. I'm afraid if he refuses to march, others may follow.
I understand.
As I said, Mrs. Kennedy, I wish there were more we could do to accommodate your wishes. I'm terribly sorry.
Don't be. You and the Johnsons have already done so much.
Good day, Mrs. Kennedy.
Mr. Valenti, would you mind getting a message to all our funeral guests when they land?
Of course.
Inform them that I will walk with Jack tomorrow, alone if necessary. And tell General de Gaulle that if he wishes to ride in an armored car or in a tank for that matter, I won't blame him. And I'm sure the tens of millions of people watching won't either.
Why are you doing this, Mrs. Kennedy?
Oh, I'm just doing my job.